are so many learnings that being shared that can be applied in our daily life experiences. Hi, my name is Frances Larney Tangonan and we are talking about contemporary Philippine arts of the region. Here are some best sites in the Philippines to see local artists work and enjoy the beauty and meaning of each Filipino paintings, Filipino sculpture, Philippine modern art, and so much more. With the skills and knowledge passed down from the masters to apprentice over the years, it depicts a modest life to prior country's great growth. Weaving is one of the most well-known kinds of traditional art in the Philippines. Keeping the culture alive, nurturing the homeland, which shows the importance of the family as a unit where the culture and tradition of the first learned and appreciated. Traditional Ilocano handicrafts like Inabel that continue to stable for the 100 years now. The Ivatan houses are made of matretic limestone and coral walls as well as the Kogun grass roofs. Here in the Philippines, there are also specialized form of fine arts, in which the artists perform their work live in the audience. This is called performance art. The traditional arts in the Philippines include folk architecture, maritime transport, famous sculpture in the Philippines, plastic arts, ornament, pottery, and other artistic expression of traditional culture.
Traditional art is part of certain group of people's culture. Now, let's talk about the Philippine region description of arts.
The country is divided into three geographic areas, Luzon, Visayas, and Mindanao. It has 18 regions, 81 provinces, 145 cities, 1,489 municipalities, and 42,029 barangays.
Cordillera Administrative Region.
Cordillera Administrative Region, street dancing and cultural presentations of the proud people from the municipalities, keeping the culture alive, nurturing the homeland, which shows the importance of the family as the unit where the culture and tradition is first learned and appreciated.
Ilocos Region.
Ilocos Region, traditional Ilocano handicrafts like Inabel that continue to tell its tales for many hundred years now. They are not only relevant to the northern region but also to the development of art and culture in the Philippines.
Cagayan Valley.
Cagayan Valley, the Ivatan houses are made of matretic limestone and coral walls as well as the Kogun grass roofs and they are sturdy enough to withstand strong winds.
Central Luzon.
Central Luzon. A statue of Philippine hero General Antonio Luna astride horse stands at the plaza in front of the cathedral on the exact spot where the brave general was assassinated in 1899.
Calabarzon.
Calabarzon. Due to the region's and natural resources, tourism plays a major role in the regional economy.
Eastern Visayas.
Eastern Visayas, San Juanico Bridge, the longest infrastructure road bridge in the Philippines spanning across a body of water measuring 2,164 meters and 7,100 feet in total length.
Zamboanga Peninsula.
Zamboanga Peninsula, known for their malong, a garment and primary weft are of cotton and supplementary weft is silk.
Northern Mindanao.
Northern Mindanao. The Lumad are composed of numerous indigenous peoples scattered throughout the Mindanao Island.
Davao Region.
Davao Region. Durian, aka king fruits, a popular delicacy in our country mostly found in Davao.
Soksarjen.
Soksarjen. Ginakit, used by Moro royalty in navigating the coastal and island waterways.
Caraga.
Caraga Region. It is known for their colintas. Colintas is all about childhood bodies separated by poverty, one of whom is invited by his classmate to join a rebel group until his conscience bother him and surrenders to the police.
And the Autonomous Region in Muslim Mindanao.
Autonomous Region in Muslim Mindanao. Dayakan, a group of Muslim ethnic group in the islands of Mindanao. They wear elaborately woven costumes tightly on their bodies.
so many learnings that being shared that can be applied in our everyday experience. My name is Frances Lauren.